Hello and welcome to Krishi Jagran Business, platform that keeps you updated with all the agri news of the nation. This is Khushi Mudgal. Let's take a quick look at the top headlines of the day. Karnataka farmers embark on tomato seedling dash. Saudi Arabia collaborates with Dutch experts to cultivate crops in arid lands. Khan undergoes revolutionary innovation and unveils first-of-its-kind 13M mounted tedder. Farmers face threats, but foreign land buyers not the culprit. Modi government's evolution and full circle moment for farm laws. Now the news in detail. With some tomato growers becoming crorepatis following the surge in prices, a large number of farmers in Chikkabellapur, Mandya, Tumakuru, Chitradurga, Koppal and Haveri are showing an interest in cultivating the kitchen staple, expecting lucrative returns in the upcoming harvest season. The rush for tomato seedlings signals a promising shift towards tomato cultivation as a profitable venture in Karnataka's agricultural landscape. In a groundbreaking collaboration, Saudi Arabia is teaming up with a leading Dutch greenhouse company to create a synthetic climate in the desert, aiming to transform arid lands into fertile agricultural zones. By utilizing advanced technologies and precision farming, the initiative seeks to make the desert bloom, boosting agricultural productivity, ensuring food security, and driving economic growth. This ambitious project not only showcases Saudi Arabia's commitment to sustainability, but also sets an inspiring example for similar ventures globally. Khan has taken a significant step in agricultural innovation by adapting its 13MGF 13003 tedder for mounting on a tractor's rear linkage, previously available only in a trailed format. This groundbreaking modification positions it as the widest implement of its type in the market, completing the French company's range of mounted GF models, which now extends up to 10M. The smartly designed compact headstock keeps the weight close to the tractor, ensuring ease of maneuverability. Although it requires a slightly larger front-end machine compared to the trailed version, this advancement showcases Khan's dedication to providing cutting-edge solutions to meet the changing demands of modern agriculture. While members of Congress, presidential candidates and state legislatures have raised concerns about Chinese and foreign investment in American farmland, the focus on foreign ownership is diverting attention from the actual crisis faced by American farmers, land grabs by domestic corporations. Contrary to the alarm raised, foreign investors, primarily Canadians, own only a modest 3% of privately owned agricultural land in the country, with Chinese ownership being even smaller. The real threat to American farmers' ownership lies within their own borders, warranting a more balanced approach to address the ongoing land ownership crisis. Over 3 years have elapsed since the Narendra Modi government introduced its three farm reform laws, initially through an ordinance in June and subsequently through Parliament in September 2020. These laws were touted as the 1991 moment for Indian agriculture. The core objective of these laws was to liberalize the trade in agricultural produce, granting farmers the freedom to sell their products to anyone and anywhere in the country. The trade area was no longer restricted to state government-regulated market yards or mandis. Additionally, traders, retailers, processors and exporters were allowed to directly purchase from farmers, entering into contract cultivation and supply agreements. Importantly, there would be no movement barriers or limits imposed on the quantity of produce they could procure and stock. That's all for today. We will be back with some more news updates tomorrow. Registrations for the MFOI Awards 2023 organized by Krishi Jagran have started. Please check out the description box to register. For more updates on agri news, stay tuned with Krishi Jagran Business. This is Khushi Mudgal.